Thank you, Mr. Chair, and thank you, gentlemen, for your testimony. I understand that both of your organizations played a role in writing the original legislation around 2001.
To be honest with you, Representative Milroy, my organization's been involved in wetland laws and rules since there have been wetland laws and rules.
Sure.
There was one in 91, there was one in 93, there was mitigation bill, I don't remember when that passed. There was Act 6, which relates to the isolated wetlands that Tom referred to, and we have been involved to one degree or another in all of those.
Well, I think it's reasonable after, I think it's been about 10 years that we've revisited Wisconsin wetland regulations. So I think it's reasonable, and I appreciate the fact that when the author of the bill testified, he said he sat down with people that are in the development community, such as yourselves and your organizations and some of the environmental groups. I think specifically one of them that testified was the Wetland Association. And the author said that not everybody got what they wanted, that some of the, that your groups wanted it to go further than it does. And I'm just wondering what you want to see in this legislation that you didn't get.
With all due respect, I don't want to be seen in opposition to the chairman. But since you asked the question, there's been a lot of discussion about the Army Corps of Engineers review and the Army Corps standards and the Army Corps this and the Army Corps that. And some of my members question, why is Wisconsin duplicating reviews that the Corps is doing? Why do we have a wetland review process? We're not required to under federal law. All Wisconsin is required to do is certify that the Army Corps permits meet Wisconsin water quality standards. Now, I think that's unrealistic. I don't think this body, I don't think Wisconsin would ever completely hand over the review of wetland permits to the Corps, but we certainly legally have that authority to do so. That's one area that we would have gone a little further down that road, at least per se discussion. But this is a good incremental step. And in Wisconsin, that's how we do these things. We do them in incremental steps. And we support this incremental step.
Like Jerry, there are just two examples on pages 27 and 28. One I already mentioned was, I think, the greater emphasis on this net environmental benefit analysis. As listed on page 28 in items 1 through 5, this net environmental impact analysis is given the same weight as all the other criteria. We think that should be the goal, a net environmental benefit, and then you use the other criteria to establish whether or not that has been met. We think as drafted, it just it places equal weight on all the items, and we'd like to see the goal being a net environmental benefit. The second one is, it probably goes even further than the bill with respect to practical alternatives. And that's currently the proposal says practical alternatives located on site or adjacent. Well, it doesn't say an adjacent site that's owned by the same property owner. It could be owned by a different property owner, a different property, and now that's going to be a practical alternative. And in many cases, that's unrealistic because that person doesn't own the property, it's not for sale, and so that's truly not a practical alternative. And again, remember, this is only one part of the analysis. If at the end of the day, the project doesn't result in net environmental benefit, even with the practical alternatives analysis, the permit doesn't get approved. So we would like to see the practical alternatives analysis even tighter to just property that's on-site or adjacent if owned by the same property owner.
One last point, if I may, Mr. Chairman, forgive me. This bill is quite a leap of faith for us as well. Tom talked about the DNR putting meat on the bones. This bill does just lay out a skeleton for those general permits. If you read the bill, I believe it's Section 83 or Section 75, gives the DNR the authority to decide what those standards and conditions on the applicant will be. We could be buying into a general permit system that my members will hate. But as frightened as I am about that process, I'm even more frightened, to be blunt, about the legislature trying to make all those technical decisions. There are some things that are appropriate for agency rulemaking and agency permit drafting and some things that are appropriate for statutes. That, by the way, is why it's not appropriate to put a big expansive list of areas that are off limits. Because, quite frankly, some of those degraded wetlands in Representative Halsey's district need protection, even though they would not be considered pristine or valuable by anybody else's estimation. So it's a big leap of faith. There's a conservative part of me that would like to see that discretion limited, but I think we have to do this in steps.
Well, I appreciate that, and I know last session you all were at the table with the reforms to the shoreland zoning regulations, and that was a 30-year struggle, and I think that the best rules and regulation in government come about when you have all of the groups at the table. And today we're dealing with changes to Wisconsin wetland laws proposal, a proposal to change Wisconsin wetland regulations. And what I'm hearing from your group is that your groups is that you're generally in favor. There's a couple of little things that you might want to see changed. What we got from the Wisconsin Wetlands legislation, I don't know if you had a chance to see their memo, but they have 8 recommendations for changes. And I'm wondering if you all are willing to sit down with the authors and the Wetlands Association to go over these concerns so that we can have a truly bipartisan bill where not everybody gets everything that they want, but we can come to a compromise where it's acceptable across the board.
I don't mean to speak for the Builder Association, but at least the Realtor Association is willing to sit down with anybody and talk about ideas people have for changing anything. So that's an open invitation.
Appreciate it.
And if Tom's there, I won't be there because I don't trust him.
All right. Well, I do appreciate the work you did last year on NR-115, and I hope that we can come to a good conclusion with this bill also.
Representative.